At 5:30, juveniles in trouble with the law, and why so many of them are minorities. It's a question Maryland is trying to come to grips with. And right now, more than 95% of the juveniles behind bars in Baltimore City are minorities.
Wow, these are the kinds of staggering numbers which have forced the state to really take a closer look at the problem. And it all started today with a statewide conference. In fact, 11 News education reporter Tim Tootin is here with more on that. But Tim, those numbers are staggering. It's amazing.
This is very serious, and it's being dealt with by experts in the areas of criminal justice, education, and mental health. But even so, these are not the kinds of problems you can solve in one day at a conference. At issue is why so many minority youths are being arrested and detained unequally all across the state.
The problems seem to start before middle school. Young people in trouble with the law for committing crimes from assault to murder. The governor's Office of Crime Control and Prevention picked the campus of Morgan State University to try and come up with solutions.
I work with a lot of young adults who have left the school system, who've been incarcerated, some really unfairly, some inappropriately charged, and now they can't get back into school, they can't go to college, they can't get a job.
State officials admit that minority youth are more likely to face the juvenile justice system than white youth and spend more time behind bars. But those attending this conference say there's enough blame to go around.
The how is about us not being intentional and conscientious about the impact by race and ethnicity on kids of color. The why is because we haven't really taken the opportunity also to determine how do we change our behavior.
But most agree the problems are larger than any one government agency. They believe accountability starts with those affected the most.
What we're trying to do today is try to recognize the fact that unless we have parent and child participation, especially those impacted by the system, we don't see real change. Right now, we can have a comfortable conversation, which is nice, but it's not moving towards positive change because we don't have that family and youth engagement.
At least one Morgan State student believes intervention should begin closer to home.
I feel like it could be done more in communities for people to uplift minorities and show them the positive views on life and positive aspects, so we can start doing positive things to uplift each other.
Now, it turns out this is the second year of the conference put on by the Governor's Office of Crime Control and Prevention. Lots of work to be done.
A lot of work indeed. Tim Tootin, thank you.